friends, I'm back again, and for this video, we are going to do mostly core work, but I'm going to call this back and core, because we're going to start off the first part of it with core work that focuses a lot on back strengthening. And this is going to be a little longer than we would, again, normally do in class, so you can easily pair this. This can be your ab workout for the day. Pair it with anything else that you're doing at home. Let's get started on our bellies. We're going to come all the way down. And we're going to just start kind of a warm-up with isolating upper and lower core here and upper and lower back. So we're aiming to get towards Superman, but first, let's just start with some chest lifts. Elbows out to the side, feet are staying down, that's very important. They're gonna wanna lift up, try to press them into the mat, and we're gonna lift the chest, lift and lower, and lift and lower, and we're just gonna do 10, 9, 8, keep going, lifting, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. Okay, now we're gonna give the chest a little rest here, and we're gonna focus on the legs. So now we're aiming to get as much of those legs off the mat as we can, and squeezing the glutes. This also uses our glute strength. So we lift. Now for 10, 9, 8. You can rest the head down, or look just in front of your mat, halfway there. We squeeze. 3, 2, and final one. All right, go ahead and just bend your knees and sway your feet. This helps to release your lower back. And now that we went through that tiny warm-up, we can go towards our Supermans. So Supermans, our arms are straight out. A modified version would be keeping your arms out to the side. You can do it that way. We're going to start with them straight out. I've got them out of the V, or you can bring them more directly out in front of you. And we're going to lift everything, arms, chest, and legs for 10 reps here. Ready? Up. 10. 9. 8. And we're squeezing everything. Now you can see why this is working the back. Halfway. 4. 3. 2. And last one. 1. Excellent job. We're going to go into some swimming. This is like a kind of a breaststroke. So for this one, we're going to hover our feet actually off the mat while we essentially try to do a kind of a breaststroke, where we're gonna sweep forward, and as we pull the elbows back in, we're lifting the chest even more. So we sweep, pushing the water away, and lifting. For 8, 7, lift, 6, lift, 5, 3, 2, and 1, last lift. All right, let's do some swimming. And we're gonna start by alternating opposite sides, but we're gonna do kind of one side at a time before we get there. So let's do, how about right arm and left leg? Opposite arm and leg. The other arm and leg can stay down. In fact, we can place it even by the shoulder as we lift. Right arm, left leg, lift. Just 8, 7, 6, swimming exercise where we alternate now from side to side. So let's start by lifting everything into a little hover. And then we lift right arm, left leg, lift and switch. Switch and switch. Switch and switch. Switch, switch, and we start to get faster. And faster. And fluttering now. Staying lifted, so keep actively lifting. Breathing normally. Keep fluttering. Five, four, three, two, and one. And wrist, rest. Whew. All right. Nice work. Pushing through the hands slowly. Finding child's pose just for a moment. Sit back towards those heels. Open your knees. And rest the forehead. Just let the lower back especially round out. And breathe. Okay, we ready for our next part? We're continuing some back work. This time with an incline plank. Let's start with a reverse tabletop because this is always your lower option. If you don't feel strong enough with the incline plank, then please keep your knees bent and just come right here. So feet hip distance apart, hands just behind the hips so your shoulders can be over the wrists. And we inhale and we lift our hips into a tabletop. Nice flat level. And we're just going to hold this first one, okay? So we're looking straight up at the ceiling. You can drop your head, holding for three, two, and one. Slowly lower the hips. Hug your knees, pull the belly in. Now, how did that feel for you? You know, be honest with yourself. There's no pressure with any of these exercises. So if that felt really challenging for you, if that was enough, and it felt challenging for me. So, you know, feel free to stay with it the second time around. If you're ready for the next step, we're gonna bring our legs out and we're gonna keep our feet together this time so we're not gonna have any space there. Think of your legs as one unit, nice and long, and we're gonna lift through the hips again. You're gonna push into those hands. Inhale, lift, and again, just hold. Dropping the head back, or if that doesn't feel good to you, looking straight up, but hold and lift through the chest. This is working those back muscles and your core and really everything in your body, your shoulders. And gently lower. And we'll take a forward fold here. Inhale and exhale. Just for a moment, hangover. Important to always do a counter stretch if we're gonna bend ourselves one way or put pressure one way, especially on the spine, then we want to do a stretch to move it the other way so we balance it out. Rolling back up. Okay, one more time. And whether you are in reverse tabletop with bent knees, you can do this. You can do some leg lifts while you're there. Or if you're in your incline plank, you can try to do some leg lifts here. Okay? We're not going to be there long. We're only going to try a few. If you want to do it longer, go right ahead. All right. Inhale, lift everything. And now lift right leg and left. And the key is try not to let the hips drop. Lift and lift. And let's do two more each side. Lift. One more. much stronger than me and you can hold it longer. And I applaud you for that. Alright, rolling back up. Okay, so that's just a little bit of back work. Feel free to do more reps for those if you like, but we're going to transition now onto our backs so we can focus now more on the core. Let's start with some crunches. These are going to be crunch variations, so we're not going to stick with just a regular crunch. Those get boring, right? Nobody wants to be doing 5 minutes of crunches. So we're going to start here with our hands overlap behind the head. And each rep we do, we're only going to do it 8 times this time, shortening it even more. But we're going to add on each time. So the first 8, we are just doing what we would think of as a normal crunch here. Heels down, and we just lift for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's lift the legs to our tabletop, and same thing, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now we're going to start to lift the hips as we crunch. We're going to be lifting towards us. So we crunch for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, this time we're going to tap our feet down as we do it. So we're going to lift 8, tap down 7, tap 6, tap. Now, this seems like such an easy move to add onto it, but you notice how it activates the core even more. 2, and 1. Woo. Now we're going to keep the chest lifted, and we're going to focus on moving the lower body. Chest stays up, and we lengthen, lower halfway, bring the knees in, up, lower halfway, in, up, and lower, in, up, lower, just halfway. Keep going. 3, 2. I'll be honest, I don't even know how many I'm counting anymore. I lost one. All right. Let's keep the chest lifted again. Legs all the way up. And this time, just the lower and a lift. Not a big one. We're keeping it Pilates style here, which really traditionally is just a little lower and lift, because we want to watch our lower back and we don't have our hands by our sides to help us. Again, I lost track of counting, but let's say we have 3, 2, and 1. Okay, we're going to rest that head down, keeping the legs up there. We're going to do a little kind of crisscross lower. So pointing the toes, you're going to cross one ankle in front of the other, and then switch. And as you do that, you are lowering, hovering, and lifting. Little coordination here. So just a few of these, maybe not 8. But point those toes and just scissor. One in front of the other. And hands can be just under your butt to help you, or your lower back even. Let's do 2 more. Lift. And last one. We're going to lift and lower. And bring it back up. And then hold here. Pull those knees in. And let's rock side to side. We are going to do a bicycle twist again, a little bicycle crunch, but we are going to do some holds with it, so it's not just going to be as we did before. Let's start actually with our feet down. We're going to work our way in, up into it. Okay, so we're going to be twisting shoulder or elbow to opposite knee, twist, and drop down. So this is again your lower option. Still feeling it, still getting a workout. Keep going here. And now you can stay with these or lift into your traditional bicycle crunch. Now I'm going to give you a way to amp this up even more. We're going to do some holds. So we're going to move a little bit faster, and we're going to do three crunches followed by a hold. So it's going to go 3, 2, 1, and hold. 3, 2, 1, hold. 3, 2, 1, hold. You really feel it in your obliques on that hold. 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 Woo, keep going. We got this. How about one more? All right, bring head back down, knees into the chest. Feel free to do as many of those that as needed for you. Challenge yourself. We're gonna hold and hug our knees, little rock side to side. And we're gonna flip over now. And you know what's coming next, because we did not do this in the last video. So we have to make up for it here with our planks, right? So we are gonna start with forearm plank. And then from the forearm plank, we will do a little bit of side plank work before we end up back in that forearm plank. Okay, so let's start. I have a little cheat sheet here so I don't forget anything. Let's start forearms down. And you can be on your knees always if you need to, or we can lift into our plank. We're going to start with some knee taps. So tap, 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 and tap. Right and left. Right and left. Holding. Ooh. And then we're going to add on a little hip dip to these. Okay, so we're going to tap right, left, right, left, and dip right, dip left, dip right, and dip left. Tap, 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 and dip, 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 and dip. Again, tap, 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 and dip. Let's do two more times. Dip, dip, whoo. And last time, dip it, last dips, and go ahead, take a quick break, push back in the child's pose, catch your breath. Those dips, again, another way you can feel that work in your obliques. And they're kind of fun too, actually. I like those. Okay, we're going to come back to our forearms, and this time we're going to make our way to our side plank. On the forearm, we're actually going to be with starting the modified side plank. So come down to the forearms and open up, and you will see why we're doing this with the bottom knee down. crunch that top leg. We're going to lift it, and then we're going to crunch knee to elbow and reach over. Crunch and reach for 8. Now, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Straight arm and leg. Lift, lift. Now for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're going to pulse our hips up, 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 and up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down. Let's try the other side. That wasn't that bad, right? I feel like we've done that longer in class. But we're shortening things again, I promise. No more than 10 reps, really, for the things that we're doing. Okay, let's try out this other side. So stack yourself up. Remember, hips are stacked. You're going to stay top hip on top of the other. Lift, extend the arm, and we crunch to begin with. And I'm going to adjust myself so because I can see my elbow needs to be under the shoulder. So you make adjustments as you need to. Crunch and reach. Crunch. Now our reps start for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, stay with it, 3, 2, nice and long, 1, now even longer as we reach for 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going to hold it and pulse up, up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower. Whew. And you do feel that in your shoulder. Over time, as we get stronger with those upper body exercises we did, these side planks, you'll notice the difference in them. They will strengthen your shoulder, but also the other upper body work will make them easier in return. So it's a cycle with everything. We are not finished with our forearm planks, but before we go to those, we're going to come to seated. And I told you this is a whole ab workout. You can treat this as your workout for the day. But we're going to start with a boat pose in this next little segment. And then we'll come back to our forearm plank. I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything. I'm looking at my cheat sheet. okay, we're good. So we're going to start different levels of boat lifting. So we're on our sit bones. And let's lift our legs. Let's try to lift them to tabletop. What does tabletop mean? It means that your shins are creating a flat surface. So we can be here. You can grab onto your legs for support. You can grab onto your calves or let go. Level one. Of course, we're not going to stay here. Well, unless you want to, you can stay here. But if you can, maybe straighten all the way out into your full boat. And then pull your shoulders back to try and keep a straight back. Okay, we got it. And then we're gonna bend our knees again, and we're gonna tap down right and left, and right and left, and right and left. So notice that I'm not really bending much more in the knees as I tap down, trying to maintain same shape of the leg. The movement is coming from the hip that's moving the leg. If I wanted to, I could move that hip down and up. Leg would stay the same. Couple more. Drop your feet down. Give yourself A little break. Inhale, nice and tall. And exhale, just round over the legs. We're going to add some twists. Next. So this time, we're going to come out to our boat, holding, but we're going to lean back a little bit more if we can. Soft arms here, so like our bar holds that we do with our arms sometimes in first position, and then we're going to twist side to side, side to side. I've softened my legs a little bit, so I can lean back a bit more. Soft, hold again, soft elbows. Twist and twist, and now come to the right side and twist, twist, pulse into it, pulse, pulse, pulse. Twist, three, two, one. Switch to the other side, pulse, pulse, twist deeper, twist, twist, five, four, three, two, one. Take another little break. Round over. Whatever feels good here, really. Hug the legs or have them straight out. And then we move into boat crunches. For boat crunches, let's start back in our boat pose, tabletop. But this time, let's keep our hands on the mat. And we're going to push out. And then back in, out and in, out, hovering and in. And this is actually, when we move it out, that's actually called half boat, which even though it's called half boat, I find it harder to hold than our full boat. Push out and in for five, four, three, two, one more. I feel that in my legs too. So it's more than just core that's at work. Okay, can we do one more boat variation? I think we can. I know we can. Okay, so for the final one, shorter even, we are going to actually move from that boat to half boat and back. More challenging, no crunch, no hands on the mat. If you need the hands, bring them back, but let's try this. This is a little different. So we're up into boat, we are holding here, and then we are moving back down into half boat. Notice my palms are up, and then we're moving back to boat, and back down, hold, move up, it's our tabletop boat, back down, and lift, woof, a few more, we can do this, lift, and back down to three more, so this is now three, hold, two, and last one, hold, and bring ourselves back up. Ooh, gosh. There's so many things you can do with boat pose. It is one of my favorites, even though it's really hard, but there's so many variations you can do to change it up, so these are just a few. Okay, we have been going for half an hour on abs, which I applaud you, it's amazing. And we're going to finish finally with back and forearm plank with a few more forearm exercises. Okay, this time we are going to go into some side plank rotators, again to help our obliques. You can bring one forearm in front of the other to make it easier to open up. You can do this on your knees and open up this way, no problem. Or you can stay on your toes. tall. Reach. Remember, these are our last couple of sets. We're going to fly through them. Stretch more. Check out the next video.